Many people who find my work are looking for a way to heal their inner wounds on another level. In this video, I show you my process of validating your own emotion. Stay tuned. I've been doing this work for many, many, many years, and one thing I like to remind my clients of is that I had to do the work first before I could teach it. I am definitely the wounded healer. I didn't just read some book and then tell you what the book said. I actually had to live the process to gain the wisdom from the experience. And I think that's something really important to know, because when you're wanting to trust someone in how to heal something or help you heal something, it's really important that you know it's a trusted process that has worked in their own experience. That's my opinion. And so I want to say that, because when I open these videos up and I push play, I don't really know what I'm going to say yet. It comes through me because it's in me. So I wanted to share my process of emotional validation with you, but first I want to explain to you why we need this. So many times people find my work because they're highly sensitive, or they find out that maybe they're codependent, or they don't know what those symptoms are, but then they find my video by some random act in the universe and they're like, oh my gosh, that's it. I have love addiction, or I have codependency, or I'm in a relationship with a narcissist or an addict or a selfish person. And the reason for this is because we are continuing a pattern that started at the beginning. I had 5 clients today. I had a really busy day. And the theme is always the same with all of them, because, you know, it's almost like this synchronization. Like attracts like. So on my Monday, I had 5 clients that had the exact same thing going on in different ways. And that exact same thing was this really, really big need to learn how to validate emotionally within self. And people who have codependent patterns or are highly sensitive or aren't healed tend to look externally. And when we look externally for the sense that I'm enough, I'm good, I'm lovable, what we often do is give up our own sense of self-love because we never anchored it. And we give too much to others. We give too much because we feel like when we give, maybe we'll be enough. And that's such a childlike thought if you really think about it. I'm a child, I'm lovable, because when I'm me, I'm loved. When I give mommy love or daddy love, I get love back. But a lot of times that's not the case. A lot of times we're giving and giving our love and it's not enough. And we anchor that thought, I'm not enough. Something about what I am isn't enough. So what we do is we try to recreate that in another pattern, but unconsciously we create the pattern with someone who's still unavailable, unable to fully love back, unable to give you that emotional validation that you need. And the reason we create that pattern is that's because we ever knew. And I ask my clients, I say, you know, a lot of people get frustrated when they start figuring it out. They think, oh, why do I keep doing this? Why can't I give this to myself? Why did I do this in the first place? And I say, hold on a moment. Let's look at your history. What was the experience with this person, this person, this person? Oh, that's why I don't validate my own self, because I was never validated. I was never approved of, is usually the case. I have one client who's a massive perfectionist. You know who you are. She's so beautiful and sensitive and brilliant, but never enough for herself. And it's funny, she's never enough for herself because she never felt enough for mom. So she will continue that pattern to validate the story. If I'm never enough no matter what, mom was right and I can try harder. I can have false control. And if I try harder, then maybe I'll get that love. But what's so interesting is the only person we're trying to get that love from any longer is you. And it's got to start with you, because if it doesn't start with you, you're going to continue to create the same pattern, which is an unavailable partner, emotionally invalidating partner, selfish partner, someone who thinks you're never enough, who doesn't really think you're of value, who makes you feel unvaluable, because the inner child in you still doesn't feel like she's enough for you. There's many aspects of this video, but for the point of right now, Let's go with that example. So how do we change that? How do we validate that? It's a very hard process, but it is very possible. If you have a pattern of emotional invalidation, of constantly saying you're not enough for your own standards, by the way, a lot of people who have inner wounds have extremely high standards. Why? Why do we have these standards? Because I need to know that I'm doing the best so that I can be enough. Because no matter what I did for mom or dad or whoever it was for you, it was never enough. So now for me, it will also never be enough. That's what you learned. So we change that by really looking at this idealistic version you've been trying to live up to and then shedding light on the real. Ideal versus real. I talk about it a lot in my videos. What is my real? Maybe I don't even know what my real is. Good way to follow this. Another client, good example. She says to me, well, how do I know I'm following my real? It could just be fear. That's your real. You are in fear right now. Newsflash. So many of us think we need to change the fear, work on a pattern that created fear, run from the fear, not trust ourselves because we have fear. The reality is you don't need what you feel to be any different at any time. That is this beginning of emotional validation. I feel fear. Okay, let me understand that I am feeling fear. That is what I that is real, and that is what I feel. So now we're going to reveal what the fear is saying. Why do I have this fear? Very easy. When you talk to fear and ask it what it's afraid of, it will tell you because it's very honest and open if you go into it. Okay, for one of my clients, she was afraid of not being enough. Okay, well, what is enough to you? She starts telling me, well, I don't know because I always have to be number one all the time. Why? Then we go into why. Very clear pattern. Mom was telling her she's not number one because there's something wrong with her in an undercover way. So now her belief is, if I'm not number one all the time in everyone's eyes, there's something wrong with me. Could never be enough. You can never be enough in every single person's eyes because every single person has different preferences and different needs. But because you're out of touch with your own needs, because you're not validating those emotional needs, you're not going to ever be able to be number one for you. So number one, get real about how you feel. I feel fear. Then get real about the fear. Why do I have fear? Then you see the message the fear tells you and you can start to, on your own or with help, go through the pattern, trace it back to another time, an early time, the first time you started to get that idea, that original wound I call it, that I'm separate from source, but now I'm going to separate from self because I don't feel like self is enough. Something about me isn't getting me the love that I need, isn't getting the emotional validation that I need. This is where that secret sauce is in the original wound. What am I feeling right now? I can trace it back to other times in my life I felt it. Holy cow, that is the first time I got that message. Now what do I need to do? Redefine the message. It might have been mom or dad that I wasn't enough for, couldn't be number one for, but why am I still making myself never enough for me? What is my preference? What are the shoulds that I've set up for me in this idealized world? And what can I replace as a real? Those quirky things about yourself, those things that you judge in others because they're not perfect. Stop yourself when you have those thoughts and say, let me be in that quirkiness for a little longer. Let me start to be more unconditional instead of depending on my conditions to know that I'm at that level. I'm enough. I'm okay. I'm number one. I deserve to validate what I feel. I deserve to feel what I feel. Many of us with inner child wounds grow up and continue negative patterns with narcissistic people or crazy people, right, in our lives because we didn't get the love we deserved at the beginning and we think it's because we didn't deserve it. But how about we reframe that and say, I didn't get what I deserved, but now I do. I didn't get what I needed, but it wasn't because I didn't deserve it. Think about that thought. Please check the links below. We have a lot of new fun things coming up. Please follow on Instagram. I always answer DMs, even if it's late. And please share and subscribe if you haven't already. Namaste.